Hello again. Somebody asked me how it would be easy to create an object that looked like it was kind of wrapping round another object, like a coil. It's kind of a coil or a spring type object. And that's my cat in the background, by the way, so if you hear some strange sounds, that's what it is. So I kind of puzzled over this for a while, and I eventually came up with these two images. As you can see, this one here is pretty symmetrical, really, and that one's a bit more random. And so I'd just like to share with you how I sort of came about doing that, and an easy way to do it. First I tried it the hard way, which is sometimes what I tend to do, but I had, let me just delete these two now that you've seen them. And here was a sort of object that I made in using the 3D settings. Let me bring my pencil here. The pencil was drawn just conventionally, rectangles and lines, and very simple that. And this was using the 3D functions of Illustrator, which is here. I use revolve and all that, and I'm not going to go into the 3D because that's a different lesson, but that's what I created, thinking, okay, yeah, now I've got that, I'll now try and figure out a way to wrap this around this object. And it proved very difficult, because when you create a 3D object, it is quite complicated. There's an invisible object there in the background, and if I just change my screen here to outline, you can see that it's quite complicated, and it's difficult to select individual parts of it and cut individual paths, and which is really what you need to do in order to get the effect of it going round another object. So it didn't actually work, so I had to come up with something else. You can try it like that, it might work for you, but I found it hard work. So this is what I came up with. Right, first of all, you need to make sure that your screen is set like this. In other words, show the grid. Okay, the grid is shown, and also snap to grid. Make sure that's on as well. Okay, so show grid, snap to grid, snap to point. Mine says hide grid at the moment because the grid is already on. Okay, might be a good idea to just memorize these keyboard shortcuts as well to snap to grid, because that's shift, command, and quote. Or if you're on a PC, shift, control, quote. Okay, right, so we've got the grid. This is what we need to do. Get the pen tool, just a normal pen tool, and we're going to start on an intersection here, and we're going to use, say, four of these squares. By the way, this is set on millimeters on mine, but I don't suppose it really matters. If it was inches, it'd be just the same. We'd end up with the same shape, but we need to create the basic shape. So click on the intersection and pull down, let's say in this case, four little squares. Okay, so we've set that point there, and then go to the diagonal of that. So I go 1, 2, 3, 4, and then so the diagonal point to there, exact opposite diagonal there, and pull that down four little squares, and you see the snap to grid helps as well. That's what we need here. Okay, now what we need to do really is to just set this to default. so that you've got a black stroke, just so we can see what we're doing. And I'll just take the fill away for the moment. Okay, so there we go. So we've got our first kind of shape. Now we've got to make this into an object. And so I'm going to select it, hold down the Alt key and just make a copy. It doesn't really matter how wide it is. I mean, that's, you know, personal choice, but I'm just going to use that one for now. So we've got two there. But of course, at the moment, there's still just two single paths. So we need to join them up and make them into a shape. And the quick way to do that is to get your direct selection tool, which is the white arrow, and just select the end points there. And we're going to use this command. There's a shortcut for it, but I'll tell you where it is in the menu, just so you know what we're doing. Path and join. There it is. So it's Command J or Control J on a PC. Okay, so I'm going to press Control J to join that up. And then here, the same. Select those two points, Command J. Okay, so now we've got our very nice first shape. So we just need to duplicate this shape, and we're going to reflect it. Now you can use the object transform reflect if you want, or you can use the reflect tool in there. It doesn't matter, it's exactly the same. So we just reflect that. That one's okay, that's reflected the way we want, and we click OK. That's yeah, that's fine. Okay, so now we've got the two shapes required for our coil or spiral, or it's not really a spiral, it's a spring, isn't it? A coil shape. Okay, so I'm just going to make these different colors just for now, because it just makes it a bit easier when we while we're using this. So there we go. So there's two different colors there, and I'm just going to put that one on top of there, so that joins nicely there. Okay, let's look at it in the outline view. I'm pressing Control Y. Yep, so that's joined up nicely there. Okay, that's fine. Right, so now I'm going to bring it to the bottom of the screen, because this works best if you go upwards with this duplicating that we're going to do now. And just press the Alt key, and just bring one up there. And then if I press Command D, we get another one and another one. Okay. So we can clearly see, I can reduce the size now of these. So we can clearly see that we have a spiral. Yeah, it's a perfect spiral. Okay, so how do we put it in the object? Well, now, because these are separate shapes, it's really easy. So let's get our pencil, and we'll just put that in there. I'll just make these a little bit smaller, hang on. Yeah, there we go. Put that on there. Now it doesn't look right yet, because the pencil is behind, but all that we have to do now is just select the parts of the spiral that need to be behind. And in this case, if you look the way this is constructed, all the greens are the back ones. So a quick way to select them all in one go, by the way, if you just go to select and same fill color, that will select all the greens in one go. And now I'm going to send them to the back. Okay, and now if you look, there we go. It's very, very nice. It looks, you know, really like it's going around that object, which is the object of the exercise. Very nice. Okay, now it's a good idea to think about some shading, you know, because that'll make it look a little bit more realistic. You can make your own gradient for this, or you can, I'll just select all the yellows, which are the front ones for now. And let's have a little bit of experimentation here. I found some gradients already made. You know, everything I'm doing is built into Illustrator. I've not even made my own gradients here. So I'm just going to choose something here. I don't know. Let's try this emerald, see what that looks like. I don't know. I don't like that. Let's try that one. Yeah, that looks nice. Okay, it looks kind of a ribbon colour, doesn't it? And then if we select all the back ones, and rather than use it, you could use the same gradient, but we, I don't know, let's just try something a bit different. No, I don't like that. Yeah, I think just a normal sort of grey looks nice. So that's, but of course, you know, you can play around with the gradient. Here, you might want it a little bit lighter in those areas. So let's just select these greys again and just have a twiddle around with the gradient here. When I find my gradient panel, oh, it's here, right. Okay, I was thinking it might be an idea to have a lighter part just kind of here somewhere. Oh, no, that's too much. Let's go here. There we go. Yeah, that's better because that brings out that just a little bit of white there. Yeah, that looks all right. So we've got a nice sort of set of gradients there. It looks like a ribbon that's, you know, got different colours on each side, doesn't it? Now, if you prefer something that isn't quite as symmetrical as that, this is the best bit about this, that you can select, well, first of all, of course, you can just select the whole thing and you can squash it up. Do something like that, yeah? Or you can, well, I'll tell you what, let me just undo that. Okay. Let's get the direct selection tool, the white arrow, and let's just kind of just select just the points of the two, those two shapes there. And that means we can individually move. You can, you know, you don't have to keep them absolutely on the same horizontal. You can move them there. Let's take this and really push that in. Oh, here we go. Push that in there. And as you can see, you know, it looks great if you, you know, if you don't want a very symmetrical object, that's great. You can pull this down or up and really make it look a little bit more squiggly like that if you want. Great, isn't it? Okay, I'm just going to put that back to about there. I think it looks sort of okay like that. And then of course the end ones here, you can maybe change those because they're at the end. Yeah. Just, you know, make sure you use the direct selection tool because you only want to select the two ends of the shape, not the entire shape itself. So there, so we've got a rather nice object there done. And if we just kind of select the thing and maybe just do that. Hey, it looks great, doesn't it? Looks really good. Okay, at this point, you know, don't be afraid to experiment. I mean, I've used those gradients and there's loads of others that you can try. I'm just going to select all the blues again and just see. I like this select same thing. It saves a lot of time, you know, and it also, you know, you don't miss one accidentally, you know. So I've select all the blue ones there, all the front ones, and like I said, there's loads of gradients that you can try. But the effects here, you know, when you go to window and graphic styles, there, all these things here, scribble effects and textures and all that, I must confess it's not something I use an awful lot, in fact not at all. But in this case, you know, there's no harm in just trying. Now some of them won't look good and some look okay. For instance, so let's try that one. Now look at that. That's interesting, isn't it? Let me just undo that. I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to select all of these for this, so we get the same effect on all of them. I think that'll be a better way to do this. And I'm just going to press Control H, which is hide. It means that everything is still selected. It just makes it a bit easier for me to show you. On the screen here. Right, so let me choose this one here. Okay, not very nice. Let's try that one. Oh, now then, that's okay, isn't it? That's called Bubble Aqua, that one. Look at that. That's interesting. You see, they're worth trying, these things. As I say, the people don't really use them that much because, I don't know, maybe they're overused, I don't know. But let's try this one. Well, yeah, it might do. You know, it's not really great, but and that one's pretty similar. That's nice. That's not bad. It's a bit like that other one. Oh, well, that doesn't work very well because of the way it joins up. Let's try this one here. Oh, right. Okay. There are others, plenty of others that we can try. If you just, I'm on buttons and rollovers at the moment in the styles, but there's a few other different ones. Let's try this one. Oh, there you go. There's an automatic kind of stroke on there, and that's nice too. You know, it's really worth just trying these different things. Let's try that one. Oh, there you go. See, I'm surprised myself. Oh, that one there's got a pattern on it. Oh yeah, that's quite nice, isn't it, with the pattern. Yeah, pretty nice. Let's go for this pinky one. There's a girly pinky one. There you go. And of course you could change the colours of the pencil to kind of match you know, the design a bit easier. I'm just going through these here now to see if I can find some really there you go. It really is worth it. We're just playing, we're just experimenting, and we're just trying these built-in things. Oh, well, that's interesting. Look at that. That is interesting, isn't it? Don't you think? Wow, looks like kind of barbed wire and cotton. And you see, and remember, you know, any object, I mean, it could be text. You know, you might want it wrapped around some text or something like that. You know, it's great, really. Very good. Let's just try a few more while we're at it, because I'm enjoying myself now. See, let's try that one. Oh, I can't do it because I've deselected it, haven't I? So let me just see if I can get it back again. Oh dear. Yeah, I'm still on this mode of hidden. Okay, let's try a few of these different things. Some of them, you know, it's quite looks like we got a snake right around there, and as you can see I missed that one, so I'll just select that as well if I can. Right, let me go back into normal and then I can see which ones I've see which ones I've selected. There we are. Okay, that's weird, that one. Let's try this one. Yeah, you see it, some of them, you know, do take a lot of processing power, and it might take a minute to, oh well, that really wasn't worth the wait. Okay, let's try some of these others. These are getting quite complicated, you see these here now. Oh well, let me hide the edges on that one. Well, that's interesting, isn't it? I'll try this one here, stone. These are all the built-in effects from Illustrator, so you know, as I say, you don't have to create anything at all yourself, unless you want to. You know, it just saves time. That's nice. That is nice, isn't it? That's this one here, which is just called metal silver. Let's try the woodcut one, see how that. Well, that's okay, I suppose. Yeah. Let's see if any more we can try while we're at it. Oh, now we're getting on to real kind of patterns here, which I don't think will work too well, because I'll just do. Well, maybe, yeah. If it had a stroke round it, it might work okay. But as you can see, I'm just playing here, but it's pretty much the end product is pretty much what we wanted with this. Let's just go back again to the final thing and just see something else while we're at it. Okay, I'm just gonna, oh, I've still got that pattern on there, which I need to remove now. You see, if you go to the appearance palette here, that's still in there, so I'll just delete that one. Actually, it looks quite nice, doesn't it? There we go. So I'm now back to sort of conventional shades and things. And also, you might want to consider having a black stroke again. So anyway, I just thought I would share that with you. You can have a lot of fun doing those spirals, and as I say, if you put it around text or something, it'd look pretty nice. Okay, hope you enjoyed that. Bye bye.